Hi friends, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Omer, and in this tutorial we'll make this block in Solidworks. This would be practice exercise 35 of this playlist, and I will provide its file in the description link so you can download it from there and you can practice. I will be using this drawing to create this part. So let's make it. Let's go to your new, select part and select OK. Now we are in Solidworks interface. So first of all, I will change my background to plain white and I will set my units to mmgs. Okay, so first I will draw this base plate and the dimensions are 128 by 65. So let's go to your top plane, select a sketch, and here I will draw center rectangle. Okay, and the dimensions are 128 by 65, so I will change its dimensions. And this dimension is 65. Okay, and here you can see that the radius is 16, so we have 4 radii 16. And I'll go to your sketch fillet, I will change its radius to 16, and I will draw 4 fillets. Okay, I will draw holes in the end, so I will exit this sketch, I will rotate my view. And now I have to extrude it in the upward direction, 12 millimeters. Okay, so I'll go to your features, extrude, I will select this contour and I will extrude it to 12 millimeter upwards. Okay, sorry, I will change it to 12. Okay, not 120, it's just 12. Okay, next is we will create this part. Okay, for this first I will create a 52 diameter hole, and I will extrude this hole to 46 minus 12, which is 34, and then I will create this part and later we will cut this portion. Okay, so I will start with this one. This sketch is 52 and it is right in the center of this block, so I will use circle, and this dimension is 52 units or 52 millimeters, and I will extrude this circle to 46 minus 12, which is 34. Okay, features, extruded boss, and I will extrude it to 34 units. Okay, and merge result, because I don't want any second solid body, so it is altogether a single solid body. Next is I will create this one, and this die is 60 and the extrusion is 12. Okay, so I will select this face sketch, and I will draw another circle. And this dimension is 60 millimeters, so I will change its dimension to 60. I'll go to your features, extruded boss, another upward extrusion, and this time the extrusion is 12, and make sure to check this box, merge result. Okay, next is I will draw this cutout, and for this I'll go to a top plane and I will draw this sketch. So I'll select this one, select a sketch, and normal. Okay, so I have to cut down this portion, and basically it is 20 millimeters away from the center line. So I will draw one line connecting these two points, and you can see that this line is not fully defined. I can drag this line anywhere, so I will constrain this line by giving a suitable dimension, and this dimension is 20 millimeters. Okay, it is a single line, it is not a contour, so I will select this circle, convert entities, and now I will trim the unnecessary part which we don't want, and this is the portion we want, and I will use cut extrusion to cut this contour up to this surface. Okay, so I will exit this sketch, I'll go to your features, extruded cut, I will use this contour, and here I will use this option up to surface, and surface is this one. Okay, so this is the cutout that we want, and now I will draw this portion. Okay, so we have a 30 millimeter dia, and then it is 10 millimeter down, and then 20 millimeter cutout, and this cutout would be through all. We can make this using a hole, basically using a counter bore, but I will create it using simple sketches. So select this surface, select the sketch, and I will draw one circle having diameter 30 units. This circle is cut through 10 millimeters. So I'll go to your features, extruded cut, and this time I will use 10 millimeter cutout downwards. Click OK. Now I will draw another sketch, another concentric sketch, and this time its diameter is 20, and this extrusion is through all. Okay, this is the negative extrusion or the removing of material. So features, extruded cut, and this time I will use this option through all and select OK. So this portion is also done, and now we will create these four holes, and these holes are basically concentric with this fillet. So basically I will select this surface, and I will draw four holes. First I will use this one, normal two, and I will drag this arc so that I can use its center. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, I will select all these one by one by holding shift button, and I will use this relation equal. Okay, I'll go to a smart dimension, and let's say this dimension is 16 millimeter. So I will change it to 16, and now you can see that all circles are fully defined. Okay, I will exit this, and I'll go to your features, extruded cut, and this time I will use this sketch, this one, and we want all circles to be cut through. So I will just clear these selections so that all contours are selected, and here I will use this option through all and select OK. So this part is also done, and now we have this rib left. So okay, so let's make this rib. I'll go to the features, and here you will find this option rib. So it is asking a plane or a planar surface to sketch the feature cross section. So I will use this one, front plane. I'll use this option, normal to view, and here I will draw one single line connecting this vertex and this vertex. And now you can see that this line is fully defined. So I will just rotate its view. I will exit this sketch mode, and here it is asking the direction of rib, which is not correct. So I will change its direction downwards, and it is showing thickness both sides. Basically we have created this line, this blue line, and the yellow lines are the thickness of the rib. Okay, so this is only on the left side, this is only on the right side, and this is from the center. So I think this one is correct, and the thickness of rib is not 10 millimeters, it is 8 millimeters. Okay, so I will change its thickness to 8, which means that 4 millimeter here and 4 millimeter here. Select OK, and now you can see that rib is also created. So after creating this part, now we will check this part using evaluate command. So first I will check this dimension, this 46. So I'll go to here evaluate, and I'll go to here measure. I will select this face, and I will select this face, and now you can see that the distance between these faces is 46 millimeter, which is correct. Next is I will check this pitch. This pitch is 96 and this pitch is 33. So I will check it one by one. Let's say this distance, it is 96, and we are checking center to center. Okay, clear these selections. I will select this one, and I will select this one, and this center distance is 33, which is correct. Okay, let's say this distance is 10. You can see that normal distance is 10 and the distance in the Z direction is 15. Okay, and let's say I will check this distance, it is 52. So I will select this edge, and here it is showing radius, not diameter, and the reason is it is not a complete diameter, it is a cutout circle, So it is showing radius instead of diameter, and when you multiply 26 by 2, so you will get 52, which is correct. Okay. Also, let's say this dia is 30, so this would be 30, okay, and this dia is 60, and here it is showing 30 because it is not a full circle. So we have checked this part using evaluate command, and lastly I will apply some appearance to this block, and let's say I'll apply some different appearance to these faces. So first I will select this face, this face, this face, this face, and this face. I'll go to your appearance color, and I will use this appearance and select OK. Similarly, for the rib, I will use green color. I will use this color and select OK. Also, let's say for the holes, I will use yellow color. This one, and these holes. I will use this color and select OK. Lastly, for the plates, first I will select these faces. And now I'll go to your colors and I will select this one. And I will select this one and select OK. So in this tutorial, we have learned how to create simple parts in SolidWorks and how to check these parts according to the dimensions, and also how to apply appearances. So that concludes this exercise. I hope you like it. And if you have any question, any query related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting projects. Thank you.